Right now, the National Weather Service is touring some major storm damage all across Central Florida, trying to determine if it was indeed caused by a tornado. Good afternoon. I'm Martha Sagowski.
I'm Jim Payne. Today was all about cleanup after yesterday's scary weather. A viewer sent us this terrifying moment from inside a Lowe's store in Orange County just as the storm hit. Customers scrambled for cover when they thought a tornado was approaching.
In Brevard County, a carport was torn right off a mobile home and hit the roof of an apartment complex, and a woman was injured when a porch roof collapsed.
Take a look at this cell phone video as the storm blew through Bay Hill, postponing the final round of the Arnold Palmer Invitational. Rain sent the crowd scrambling for cover and caused some damage.
We do have team coverage this afternoon. First Alert meteorologist Jason Brewer has what the storm left behind. Meteorologist Dan Billow has an update on the woman hurt in Cocoa. But first, let's get right to Michelle Meredith in Orange County. Michelle, you just spoke with the National Weather Service.
I did just speak to the National Weather Service. They've wrapped up their investigation in Lake County, and they tell me in Lake County, a tornado did not touch down in Lake County. Yes, it had some strong winds, but no tornado. For most of Central Florida, Monday is the day of reckoning, the day to clean up and deal with Mother Nature's fury. In College Park, a huge oak on Yale Street completely blocked the road, the roots sticking straight up in the air, a testimony to the power of the storm. Did you hear this tree?
We didn't. We were in the house and then we came outside when the storm was over.
And what were you thinking?
We couldn't believe it. It reminded us of the hurricanes back in 2004.
The storm front that passed through Central Florida Sunday afternoon was short but not so sweet, packing winds up to 80 miles per hour. Thousands lost power. At one point, Orlando police reported 100 traffic lights out of commission. Trees fell on homes. Trees fell on cars. The National Weather Service tells us the storm moved west from Lake County to Brevard. Today, they were in Lake Louisa Park in Lake County, where trees snapped like twigs, trying to figure out exactly what we were dealing with Sunday.
During most of that track across the state, there were wind gusts of anywhere from 50 to 80 miles per hour, straight line winds pushing from west to east. And what we think may have happened was within that overall swath of damage, there may be enhanced damage from some tornado touchdowns.
Now, the crew from that National Weather Service, they're on their way here to Orange County, to Windermere, Ocoee, where we are. As you can see, this is another tree in Windermere that took a hit. And their goal is to see if a tornado touched down in this neck of the woods. Live in Orange County, Michelle Meredith, WESH 2 News.
Power crews have been working since yesterday to get everyone's electricity back on. And at the peak of the storm, 50,000 local homes were without power. Right now, Progress Energy is reporting 824 customers without power. Orlando Utilities has more than 1,200 homes without power. And Florida Power and Light reports 63 customers with no electricity. WESH 2's Dan Billow continues our live team coverage in Brevard County. And Dan, one woman had to have surgery today after a roof fell on her.
The damage around here, Jim, was widespread and a lot of it very costly. If you take a look at all this, the metal here used to be part of a roof and a carport of this mobile home. All this stuff was on the other side of the building at one point, and the homeowner here says it looked like a tornado to him.
Some of our parts went down that way, and then the rest of us went that way.
I heard the freight train noise, and that's when I yelled to my wife and the kids, get in the bathroom.
Perhaps the worst of the damage in the Maplewood section of West Cocoa was here, where a roof collapsed on a woman who was out trying to save her poodle, Sadie, from the storm. The falling Florida room pinned her underneath.
She's never been in this much pain in her life, and she was screaming, "Do something about my leg."
Today, the victim has what doctors call the worst broken hip they've ever seen. She's getting it replaced. In Titusville, dime-sized hail came down as the storm hit. The winds overturned a plane landing at Arthur Dunn Air Park.
Where it was just walls of rain. I mean, it was just so intense you couldn't really see in front of you.
It seems unreal.
And in Cape Canaveral, the roof came off an apartment complex, badly frightening the tenants.
I was worried that the whole place was going to come down. I grabbed my brother by the shirt, threw him outside, and called 911 immediately.
At 5 o'clock, you'll hear the 911 call from where that woman was trapped under the wreckage. You'll also see the damage at a popular local radio station, WMEL, knocked off the air.